Hey, what's up guys, here and today welcome to another video on my channel. And today it is a weird one, an interesting one. Now, I've done a rant video before about FIFA. I've even done a video kind of exposing, you know, some of the bullshit parts of FIFA, you know, like the goals disappearing and just kickoff boost, some weird ass glitches in the game, man. And we've already discussed about this. But for once, it's actually not me that's really raising an issue. Now, there is a hashtag going around over Twitter, and you've probably seen it around YouTube. There's been YouTubers like Nepenfez and many others like that just discussing about this, and it's something called hashtag FitzFIFA. Now, this has gone massive on Reddit and all pages similar to that. That is basically almost like an uproar, and this is kind of weird because we've never really had something like this in the FIFA community, that it feels more than just kids complaining on Twitter. It feels more than just you know, just general annoyance of the game. It just feels more than that. There's a Reddit post, I'll put it down below in the description. It's quite big, but it basically goes through point by point of what really has a change about FIFA in comparison to different games across all platforms. I believe that Nepenfez did a 29-minute video or something like that, discussing his thoughts of the hashtag FitzFIFA, which I would highly recommend to check out as well, because he probably explains it a lot better than what I could ever do. Now, I've been playing FIFA since FIFA 03. Now, of course, haven't really been playing competitively or, like, actually since, like, FIFA 11, because by then I would have been, 13 years old, so that I could actually have a more of a grasp of what a controller is and what an Xbox is. Just so you know, so I can actually kind of play FIFA and kind of do alright and not just get destroyed each game, because you know, when you're 12, 13 years old, you usually just get smashed each game. Let's just go through this Reddit post, and we're going to go through each point and give my thoughts in it and what I think should be done by EA. And let me know, lads, down below in the comments. This is more of a discussion kind of video. I want to discuss with you guys down below, or you guys can discuss between each other. What are your thoughts about FIFA? What should be changed? If anything should be changed, is it an upgrade from FIFA 17? Let me know your thoughts. So, this is how it starts off. Basically saying, you know, discussing about how, you know, he started off playing FIFA since FIFA 04 to FIFA 18, and he brings up about currency, about fuel points or the premium currency, which you can only buy with actual money. You buy packs with them, and you can buy a premium gold pack for 7,500 coins or $1.50. $1.50 for a 7.5k pack, which has 12 cards, consumables with only 3 rare items, which is about £1.30, £1.20 odd for, you know, £1.20 odd for a 7.5k pack. So, number one, extend weekend league by one day and plan to revamp FIFA competitive, revert FIFA 18 to launch date with a few minor changes, remove the kickoff boost the opponent gets when they concede, fix the EAS SC catalog so players can level, fix player jersey numbers changing randomly, fix the menu D-pad delay, fix the penalty taking glitch as described below. So that's straight away, he's mentioned some points there. So let's start off with the first one. Extend weekend league by one day and plan to revamp FIFA competitive. Now, there's not much you can really change about FIFA, in my opinion. Now, honestly, I don't play weekly because I don't have enough time for it. I don't have the patience for it. I don't have the concentration to play it. I think that weekend league is more about keeping your head than actual player skill. If I could put it down as like a percentage of like 100%, that I think FIFA is about 40% luck, 40% animation, game mechanics, the actual game playing it for you, and 20% skill. Now, you may say that that's quite, you know, that seems quite, you know, quite bullshit, that, you know, there's huge gorilla, you know, he could play against someone like me or, you know, a 13-year-old, and he should win each time, he should demolish them, which I understand. But when it comes to, you know, competitive, we aren't talking about the common player. We're talking about when it comes to the nitty-gritty, and now when it comes to competitive matches at the FIWC, at the regionals, and that's how I see it. I believe that when you got two evenly, you know, skillful players that knows how to take advantage of the game mechanics just as well as each other, it's luck. The bouncers and stuff like that. The thing is, EA can't really change that much because there's only so much you can do with 11 players and one ball, or 22 players on pitch and one ball. There's only so much you can do. Talking about game mechanics, animations. Now, my favorite FIFA to play personally is FIFA 13. I love just the speed of it, the dribbling, it's so fast, it's so fluid, but it's unrealistic in terms of FIFA. And of course, FIFA want to make it, well, not FIFA, EA want to make FIFA a more realistic game. So they've added more animations to make it feel more realistic, which I understand that, but it's a game at the end of the day. I play a game, I'd rather have it more arcadey than to have it more realistic, because what you don't understand is that when you add more animation, the more animations you add to a player, the more weight you add to the player, the more that is out of the player's hands. Now, you can kind of say that if it's the same thing for both players, then it's still a consistent ground. But that's not the point, that they add more animations to make players move slower than for what the actual player with his controller is telling them to do. That extra half a second can mean between you winning hundreds of thousands of pounds, which is what the prizes are at these tournaments now. Hundreds of thousands of pounds on the line, and most of it is out of players' hands. That's my thoughts on it. So, should they extend it by another day? I would want them to, but it kind of takes away the actual skill, I guess. It's not skill, it's more of the actual composure of a player, that can he keep his nerve. Now, of course, they want to keep it very short, so it's more intense and more so. It creates a skill gap between, you know, the alright FIFA player and the pro. Yeah, it creates a skill gap because the pro, which may not have an actual job, FIFA could be their job. Being a pro FIFA player could be their job, and they have more advantage to the other player that, you know, they have actual jobs. They work at Mackey's on the weekends, they work at Tesco, those kind of people, that they want to become a pro, they wouldn't mind to, you know, stay at home playing FIFA, that'd be sick, won't it? You know, for me, for myself, I got football, I go all Burnley games. Now, that's not saying anything like, poor me, that's my choice, because I'd rather go to football matches and support my team than play FIFA. So that's my thought. So next one, I know I talked about that for quite a while, but it's just what I think. I've been playing FIFA competitively, I guess you could say, since FIFA 12. I used to play Virgin Gaming back in FIFA 12, you know, competing for like £10, £15, I'm thinking I was playing for like 10 fucking grand. And you know, I would have been about 13. Next, revert FIFA 18 to launch date with a few minor changes. Now, I don't understand that, because I guess people say that when FIFA 18 came out, it was a lot better, passing was a lot better, and all these other factors. But it says with a few minor changes. Whatever EA change, you can never please everyone. And you say with a few minor changes, what minor changes? Maybe he says that later on in the actual Reddit post, but no matter what EA change, not everyone's going to be happy with what the game turns out to be. If the goalkeepers are too hard, goalkeepers too easy. If pace is more effective, if passing is too easy, too worse. The dribbling is too shite. Defensive lines is like, you know, they do too much for them, or they don't do enough for them. EA, I'm on side with EA in that one, that you can't really please everyone. Now, it is a bit annoying that started the game, you get the game, and then 1 week into the game, or a week and a half into the game, it completely changes. I understand that, the frustrations from that, and I'm on, you know, the Reddit's, the Fits FIFA kind of more, you know, movement side of things. That next one, remove the kickoff boost the opponent gets when they concede. Now, it's another weird one for me, because it all depends on if you believe momentum is in the game. If you believe that when you score, or when the other player's at a disadvantage, that the game purposely makes either one player's more better or more fluid, or makes better runs, or just is more intelligent than the other teams, or like, you know, the defensive lines. People refer this back to sliders, saying that when you score a goal, it's almost like your defensive position and your defensive intelligence is got, you know, it goes from like 50 to like 25 in the first 10-15 seconds of a game. Now, you guys can decide if you think that it is in the game, if kickoff boost is in the game, momentum in the game. I believe that there is, I don't think there's such thing as momentum, but I do think there is certain stats in the game that combines together, which means that one player, after you concede a goal, morale-wise and maybe their personality, can perform better or can perform worse on either side of the coin. That's what I think, lads. Kickoff boost is annoying, and yes, it is a lot more prominent this year compared to previous FIFAs. I think that they should do a thing. They need to tweak it a bit when it comes to not just attacking, it's just defending. Defenders just don't defend. They seem to be a lot more sloppy, so maybe just lower that down a bit more of how drastic that is. Other than that, not really many other issues. Things like fits the ESFC catalogue I've never had an issue with that, so I'm not that too bothered about that. Could be an issue for some people. For me, not really had an issue with that. Fits player jersey numbers changing randomly. Yet again, it's a cosmetic issue. It's not really a gameplay, you know, gameplay destroying issue. So yeah, it's a little tweak, but that's not a big issue, of course. And fits in menu D-pad delay. That is a bit annoying, but very annoying, in fact, when you're on the menus and there is a delay with your D-pad. Very annoying. It's not fluid compared to other FIFAs. And sometimes I've seen people literally buy now list their card. People have like listed Ronaldo's for like minimum buy now because of D-pad delay. They're supposed to, like, you know, just go down and open them, but it just doesn't do it for them, and they list them up and they just lost like 800,000 coins on Ronaldo. I've seen that happen before and it's bullshit. And also fits the penalty taking glitch as described below. But yeah, there's some penalties that you go the right way and your goalkeeper just, like, it kind of goes shoulder first. You've probably seen the samples before that, or you've played FIFA before, that you go the same way that they're going, but your goalkeeper just takes a weird ass dive and it's almost like the ball's purposely supposed to go past him. We've already happened to us and happened against us as well, that it's been in our favour against our favour. It's happened on both sides of the coins, which, as you could say, maybe it's, you know, it's consistently shit. I guess you could say that. There's that. So let's get into the actual points. I know I talked for a while there, but it's important to get my into discussion video. So, of course, down below, let me know your thoughts down below in the comments. So, next up, the packs are completely NRG and have terrible drop rates. To be fair, I should know what NRG is. I think it means pay to win, but I don't know. You can either spend $1.50 and get the best player in the game, or spend thousands of dollars and get nothing. People with the best team in the game have spent a whopping $8,000 plus to acquire it, which is absurd, especially for a yearly game. Now, I haven't said that much of a big issue with packs. I think packs is very, I think it depends on the type of person that it is. I know that people aren't that good at, you know, keeping hold of their money. Like for me, I've literally put like £15 into the game, which is at the first, the start of the game, and that's really it. I put nothing really into it, because I know there's so many other ways to make money in the game, and make coins in the game. Foot champions, squad battles, SBCs, so many things. So I know that it's actually not that hard to get a really good team. Now, of course, I do know it takes time, it takes a lot of time, but I don't mind that the more time you put into a game, or the more better you're in a game, a bit of luck as well when it comes to, you know, stuff like SBC, stuff like that, the better squad you get, the more coins you get. I don't understand the massive issue with that. Now, of course, people say there's terrible drop rates. I don't think the drop is not that bad compared to other FIFAs. I'm seeing a lot more people pack, like, you know, not the Ronaldos and Messis of such, but more of like the mid-range players, like, I guess the Sanchez's, the Aubameyangs, the I guess like the Robins, and, you know, mid-range kind of almost 100k round players, the Kakus. Players like that, I've seen a lot of people pack them compared to previous FIFAs, which back then it really was absurd of how much you had to put into the game to actually do well in the game. Go back to FIFA 15, FIFA 16, that literally people just bought coins. That's why coin sellers was such a massive thing back in those days, because it was absurd to try and get to anywhere near the squad you wanted without literally putting a mad amount into the game, and I mean a mad amount playing the game, or just getting lucky in packs, which means I have to put money in the game to get packs. That's the only way that you could get coins in the game. Back in FIFA 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and I guess even 16 as well. Even though they did have foot draft, but didn't really make it much difference. It's only really been since FIFA 17 that you've been able to actually get a lot of coins without actually putting money into the game. So next one. Yeah, I've changed again from launch. Launch FIFA 18 was incredibly smooth. It felt like the best FIFA game ever. Too many. I bought the game days after launch, watching gameplay, and boy, was it amazing. Alas, EA made the game terrible and not what people purchased. They changed everything. Defending is now fully assisted. Gameplay feels slow. Goalkeepers save almost every shot. And the game is not fun nor competitive anymore. EA made the game catered to casuals after the patch. Gameplay does feel very, very slow. Goalkeepers, it's kind of, you know, one game they're overpowered, one game they're not. That's an issue with many FIFAs, in my opinion. Defending is now fully assisted. It is a bit. I'm just gonna compare this to previous FIFAs. That I don't think that the defending, like the assisted, you know, let's say if you just literally have your controller, drop it, you're not touching your controller, and your own defenders kind of auto defense for you, like move around and try and track runs. It's similar to what most FIFAs are like, well, especially last one. Now, of course, last one was quite annoying as well, which I'm not saying that it's a good thing, you know, I'm not trying to lower it down, but it's not really a massive difference compared to last FIFA, in my opinion. The main point from this that I agree 100% is the fact that EA changed the game after people purchased the game, and they changed the game completely. People purchased the game, put money into the game. For some people, you know, spending £50 for a game for some people is a lot of money. Kids, you know, their parents buy FIFA for them, and that, for some parents, that's a lot of money to fork out for a new game, £50 almost. And I understand the frustrations. That is not the game that they first purchased. And now he's on about Weekend League, and we've already talked about Weekend League before, just on about how Granny is playing 40 games, that there's pro players that's literally just stopped, that they just quit being a pro FIFA player because it literally takes so much time out of their life. And I can imagine that just frustration completely. I can't imagine playing 40 games each weekend. I've literally only ever finished 40 games in, you know, for Weekend League twice in the last year and two months. I've only done it twice. And those were the worst fucking weekends of my life. When it comes to higher in the ranks, when you're like a top 100 player, that it's not that competitive, that when you can literally just avoid other pro plays, there's kits that you know which ones to avoid, and people sometimes just choose to be the home team because that's more likely for them to not face a pro player. But as a pro player, they all want to play at home because I think that just gives them better connection. It's not really that competitive because not many top 100 players usually face each other, and when they do, it's quite rare. Now, one thing that this lad said that can combat this issue is to make it so that you don't know if you're home or away. Almost like head-to-head seasons, that you just go into a game, there's no menu, there's no lobby, you literally just go straight into a game, power you in a game, sort of. You have no idea who the other team is, what their kit is, nothing at all, what the stadium is, you have no idea. There's a standard home and away kit and what a same stadium. Like the FIWC stadium. Like every game will be played at the FIWC stadium, for example. But that is a decent idea. People may not enjoy it because they want to wear the kits. They want to represent the team. It means that it's a lot more competitive and that the bigger pro players can play each other even more. I'm all for it. And in here we just discuss many other things such as penalties and EA catalog, and EA only care about FUT in a lot more detail, so if you want to read that, feel free. There are many other things about FIFA that's annoying, about the goalposts disappearing and just shit like that, and balls going through players, like literally going through their legs, going through their bodies. One player in 90 minutes has a long shot and it goes through your player's leg or goes through his arm or his fucking face to then just go top bins back in the net. Frustrations like that, I understand completely. So he then says, here what you can do. So number one, boycott Black Friday, basically a lot of promo packs, and that they will give, you know, a certain amount, like 100k packs, and like, you know, each hour or something like that. And basically just saying just to not take part in it, don't buy FIFA points, and just don't take part in it at all, really. I don't know what it would do. People saying boycott Black Friday, and people even saying boycott the game. Boycott FIFA. Boycott FIFA's not gonna do shit. It's just not gonna do shit. They already have your money. They already have your money from the game, so I don't know what that's going to do. Boycott Black Friday, it can make a bit of an effect, but in the grand scheme of things, across the entire world, I don't think it will. There's people that don't even watch YouTube and Reddit. You know, there's footballers that just don't care about money, and they just put money in the game. Rich kids from Dubai and fucking Saudi Arabia, they probably don't watch YouTube, and if you do, they probably just don't care. So yeah, spend about £5,000 of your dad's fucking money in the game. It's great. In the grand scheme of things, I can't imagine it making a difference. Of course, it's a good thought, and that I'm all for it. I mean, I don't put me in the game anyway, so it's not a big issue for me. So number two, tweet EA Sports FIFA. We'll be using the hashtag FitsFIFA. Believe me, if this explodes, it will have a big impact. Look at how they react to the Battlefront community. If you don't have much time, just tweet the hashtag at them. It helps the case. The thing is, EA has never really been like, they never really reacted to these situations. They just kind of speak quiet about it because they kind of already know that they already control. Nothing will change with FIFA, I believe, until PES really actually does something good. Or even like another game steps up, which I doubt that's ever going to happen. There's no games like FIFA with how in-depth FIFA is, the community FIFA has. PES has nowhere near the community that FIFA has. They already know that they are the biggest fish of a tiny, 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 tiny fucking pond. They already know that. The only way that it's going to make a difference is the big, big lads. That's really, really into, you know, that's connected to FIFA. Like Castro and like Spencer Owen. People like that. But even with that, they still don't have much of an impact. They're just social influencers. they can give them tips on how to, you know, the community wants this, community wants that. But at the end of the day, there's not much that we can really do, in my opinion. Now, maybe you guys have proved me wrong. He says number three is, well, if you're a big YouTuber or you're just a normal YouTuber like me, please join the movement. You will seriously help our cause and will be a huge impact on all this. Make a 2-minute video or make a long video discussing everything in this post. Hi. What's wrong with FIFA currently? The more attention it gets, the better. I'm all for changing the game. I'm all for it. I'm not gonna diss what you're trying to do here. Like, fits FIFA. I don't think boycotting anything will make a difference. I don't think, is harassing even a word? I think the only way that anything's gonna really change the game is when a massive social influencer or all of them all come together and really just say this is what the community wants. Just say how it is. The one frustration I have with EA is that they don't really talk much. They rarely ever do. And when they do, it's from a standalone account of one guy that works there that barely anyone really follows. So no one actually sees the information. Now, sometimes, you know, big YouTubers like Bates and them can like retweet it to help, you know, let the community know. But EA never released a statement on their websites, on the actual FIFA game. They never released a statement. They very communicate about patches, about what it actually does, what the drop rates are of packs. They rarely ever do. The first step is to try and break that boundary so that EA are a bit more in connection with the FIFA community. Number four, sign the petition. So there's a petition down below also that if you want to sign. Let me just click on it as well. I'm kind of curious of how many people has actually signed this. 12,477 signatures. It wants 15,000 potentially. Okay. And lads, I'm just going to leave it here. Let me know your thoughts. I've talked for a long time about FIFA. This isn't a rant video. It's more just like understanding frustrations, understanding what other people feel about the game. There's a lot of things about the game that is annoying, just like every FIFA, but this is different. When EA wanted to become a more competitive game, esports game, you could put all the money you want into it, but when it comes to actual skill, it's just not there. And maybe that's not really EA's fault. You got 22 men on a pitch with one ball and two nets. You can only control one player at a time. It's not EA's fault massively, but there is some things in the game that does need tweaking a bit. And it's not even just tweaking it, but it's letting the community know what they're tweaking, why they're tweaking, how much they're tweaking. I think the community can be a lot more understanding if they just tell people what they're doing, other than every now and then there's one standalone Twitter account that no one really is following, no one really knows, just tweets out stuff, and no one sees it. There's no point in that, is there? There's really no point. So that's my thoughts on it. Let me know your thoughts down below. Make sure to smash that button as did. Subscribe if you're new, lads. And yeah, this is my thoughts on the Fits FIFA, hashtag Fits FIFA movement right now. And yeah, I'll see you guys in another video. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Biz. I'll see you next time.